This is the temple of Shri Shanta Durga, one of the beautiful temples of this taluka. It's in Vere, Bardes taluka of Goa. And she's the goddess of peace, as well as she's the goddess who supposed to give a lot of soothingness and calmness to the devotees who come here. She has two forms, the fierce and the calm. Shant means cool, calm, serene. And the word Durga, the name Durga, signifies that she had killed the demon Durgam.
Estamos no templo de Shanta Durga, em Veren, em Goa. A palavra Shanta Durga, que é o nome de uma deusa tipicamente goesa, não indiana, mas goesa, só por si dava para fazermos um programa sobre isso. Porque a deusa hindu, que é a deusa Durga, é uma deusa que castiga, é uma deusa associada ao poder, à maldade. E os goeses, que são um povo muito suave, eles gostam de se autodenominar um povo sossegado, criaram uma versão da deusa Durga muito mais suave, a que chamam Shanta Durga. E Shanta quer dizer isso mesmo, Shanta quer dizer cool, quer dizer a Durga suave. E isto corresponde ao tema do nosso programa. O tema do programa de hoje é sincretismo, que no dicionário de português eu tive que vir ver porque era uma palavra que me fazia à cabeça alguma confusão. Sincretismo é uma amálgama de conceitos heterogéneos, ou seja, é um momento em que se cruzam várias influências de várias filosofias ou de várias religiões. E Goa é tipicamente um bom exemplo disso. É um lugar em pleno século XXI, onde em todo o mundo se travam guerras pelas exclusividades religiosas, os muçulmanos querem ser só muçulmanos, os hindus querem ser só hindus, os cristãos querem ser só cristãos. Aqui em Goa há uma coabitação pacífica de todas estas religiões e de outras, e mais engraçado, ou mais curioso, é o facto de as práticas, os rituais, terem uma enorme influência uns dos outros. Para nos ajudar a compreender este fenómeno, convidámos Rohit Falgonkar, um professor de história, um historiador, famoso como ativista pela preservação do património aqui em Goa, que gostávamos que nos ajudasse a perceber o que é o fenómeno do sincretismo em Goa. Rohit. Please try to help us understanding how in Goa this phenomena of syncretism, of how religion practices are melted. And if you can give us an idea, a kind of historical background, how was this possible? I mean, how did we arrive to such a beauty way of existing all in peace and all together? Practicing, going to the temples, having Hindus going to Christian temples, having Christians go to Hindu temples. What happened in this little territory that allowed this to arrive to the 21st century and still being a very strong part of Goan traditions and identity?
If you allow me to dwell into history of Goa, it's the ancient history, somewhere in the 11th century, you have the Kadam kings, who actually was on a voyage to Gujarat from here. And his ship wrecked in the middle of the Zuaris. And there you find he being helped by a Muslim, an Arab merchant, whose name was Muhammad. And he was a chief of a settlement over here called as Hanjaman Nagar. And this particular settlement was fully of the Muslims. So here you find the first instance, the recorded instance in Goa's history, wherein you have Muslims also staying along when the Goa was under Hindu kings. Later on, his grandson, the king's grandson, that Kadam king's grandson, Jaikeshi I, the first, he appointed that Arab merchant's son as a governor of Goa. And the son's name was Chaddam. Probably he was Saddam. So here you find the one of the early references or records wherein you find two communities seem to stay in harmony.
Let me see if I understood. So there was an Hindu king which was appointing a Muslim also king of his territory,
Muslim governor,
to be the governor of a province of a...
Yes. So these are some of the early recorded evidences. Of course, you have unrecorded also, meaning written evidences, wherein you have a very good gelling between the Hindus and the Muslim, two different communities. As you progress, history takes us to the Portuguese period after 1510. You find the Portuguese coming here, and Inquisition was laid in somewhere in 1560. During this period, during the Inquisition period, you find many Hindus who are not ready to convert flee from the Portuguese territories of Goa, and they take shelter in the territories which are not under the Portuguese, and mostly they were under the Adil Shah of Bijapur, Idalgaon. And when it was abolished, 1774 to 1778, this period, the 4 or 5 years, you find there's a lot of relief given to the people of Goa.
O Rui falou-nos numa questão muito interessante, que é a forma como os goeses, durante a Inquisição, se mudaram para o lado lá da fronteira. Ou seja, houve muitas famílias que se não queriam converter ao cristianismo, hindus, portanto, que durante o período da Inquisição atravessaram o rio e foram viver para fora do território de Portugal. Como vimos, sob a proteção de um rei muçulmano. O que é curioso é que este fenómeno ficou associado ao folclore local e o conceito de atravessar o rio é um conceito de proteger a sua cultura e a sua identidade. O conceito, digamos, em sentido contrário, no princípio do século XIX, ou no final do século XVIII, com a introdução das ideias da Revolução Francesa, e, portanto, das ideias humanistas, tipicamente conhecida a época do Marquês de Pombal, os goeses regressam desses territórios onde viveram 200 ou 300 anos, para as terras de onde eram originários e trazem o mesmo ícone que tinham levado. Portanto, o conceito do templo hindu é diferente do conceito da igreja. As igrejas são estabelecidas na paróquia, as pessoas mudam de paróquia, portanto mudam de igreja. Os hindus não. Os hindus, quando vão para outra terra, levam consigo o seu Deus protetor, o Deus da família, e quando regressam à terra natal, trazem de novo. Portanto, é interessante notar que durante o período do Marquês de Pombal, muitas famílias regressam às terras natais e templos que tinham sido destruídos em Goa durante o tempo mais severo da Inquisição, voltam a ser construídos. Hoje encontramos muitos templos em Goa que não são necessariamente pós-libertação, ou seja, depois de 1961, mas que já vêm desde do princípio do século XIX, final do século XVIII, desde o tempo em que o Marquês de Pombal acabou com a Inquisição e introduziu estas novas ideias.
Thank you. We had a Ganesha temple in the island of Divar, and this temple was destroyed in 1515. And the deity of this temple was thereafter shifted to Narve of Bishuli. And for some reason or the other, it was felt that it should be taken to a place called Kandola. And there, this deity was kept and worshipped. Lot of Christians do visit this temple, like we do. Now, our family has been very close to Lord Ganesha from earlier times. We, even today, go to this temple once a year, give our offerings, and make it a point to keep this tradition going. There are a lot of Catholics also we come across who visit this temple. There may be various reasons, but as far as we, our family is concerned, is that this temple was in close vicinity of our house, our ancestral house. And probably in those days, the family did go there, and since we come from basically from a Hindu background, mm-hmm. we come from a family called Mamai Kamat. And maybe that our worship to this deity has started at that time, which we have continued the old tradition. Even in this house, we have a Lord Ganesha. That shows how close we are with the Hindu religion.
हाँ हम गेता हम सरीम गेता हम माँ जो जो आरे गड़े मावन गेता जाने कितने गड़ागड़े इंटे गड़ने मत कितने वाइट जाता कितने ना था जो उन जा विचार था करते ना था जो संगता कितने खारेंगे कितने तो चुकलां दला कितने दाता थे सब लोग आगरे विचार में तो जो संगता ये चुकले ना था ये सांगों थे सांग पाते अच्छे से यहाँ पर उनके जो गीता
23 कौल सर देर 23 कड़ी कड़ी भी कॉल इट एंड ईच कड़ी हैज गॉट सर्टन मीनिंग Suppose first five, second five, in the middle three, then five, five again. So this first five means on the right side of the goddess, our left side. So we call last three, they are good ones. In the middle one is there, that is the best. Then second one, this little less. And third one, your work will be done, but it will take time, like that. And the left side of the goddess means our right side. There are three petals like this, and is the meaning in the negative. That is one of the Devzar, means Rakhandar guard. Then Khetri means those who are died by accidental death. Devzar, Khetri, Samman. Samman means we call it Brahman also, or serpent also.
So each petal is representing each yes. spirit or a yes. person, or a dead, or an
yes,
entity.
Yes, or a right, wrong, right.
Okay, so accordingly the goddess gives the consent. Okay. So the petal which falls down.
Yeah, if his right third falls, it is very nice. If it is left falls, we will say, no, you don't go forward. You have got no, this thing, God's blessings for this.
काम किती म्हणता बरें तर असं जाय आपलं बरें जावपाचें असं जाय जाल्यार तर उजी दी म्हणटा आणि बरें जावपाचें ना जाल्यार दावे पडले जाल्यार वायट म्हणटा
And who interprets it? Who decides that the goddess had said so and so thing?
So one pujari devari is there and one assistant is outsider.
So the main priest explains.
हय देवीन म्हाका खूब अशें असें हा बरें दोन दवरलां
तांचे खुबशे प्रस्न आसतात मुख्य म्हणजे काजराचो किंवा हे मच्छीमारी लोक आसा पळय तांचे पानवटाचो म्हणजे नुस्तें मेळपाचो अशे खूब तरेचे प्रस्न आसतात
हय तशें कितें म्हाका जाय तें हांव बरें ना जाल्यार सुद्दां कितें सांगलें जाल्यार ती कडेन बरसात म्हाका जाल्यार बरें जाता
देवी ही मुळांत खंयची म्हणटी खूबशे आख्यायिका आसात. एक कराडे साकून आयली अशी एक आख्यायिका आसा, एक बाणावले साकून आयली म्हणून आख्यायिका आसा, अशें खुबश्यो आख्यायिका आसा. म्हणजे पूण खरी खंयची म्हणटा कोणाकच खबर ना. पूण बाणावलेचे लोक बी मुद्दाम हांगसर क्रिस्तांव येतात देवा कडेन प्रसाद कौल घेवपाक, तांचे काजार बिजार किंवा अशी कितें कामां म्हत्वाची आसली जाल्यार. आनी वार्शीक ते देवाक एक निवेद दितात, पट दितात.
या आय ब्रिंग वन कोकोनट मिल्क राईस अँड फ्लावर्स दॅट वे टू विजिटर ऑयल ऑल्सो.
You are basically a Christian Bible.
Yeah, yeah.
Okay, and you believe in this goddess.
Yeah, yeah. She do all my work. What I ask with my own heart, like, no? She comes in my need and she do all my work. She never refuses, like. Because that I comes and visit her. I believe in everything. There is nothing. So all people are, means all humans are in one unity, like, no? Hindu, Muslim and Christians are in one unity. There is nothing, like, no? All gods are one, like, no?
आता पयलीं खूब लोक येताले. आता हल्ली हल्ली कितें जालें, ते केरळाचे पोटार ते पाद्रींनी मातशें तांकां हें केल्या, ती देवळांनी वचूंक जायना बी अशें म्हणून ते मातशें हें केलां, पूण कमी पूण येतात.
वॉट वॉज टोल्ड टू मी एन्ड वॉट आय फावंड इन द डॉक्युमेंट्स, we were converted in 16th century. We had lot of priests later on, but before that we were Hindus. After my marriage, that is after 54, when I got married, I saw there on the carnival, second day of carnival, they were dressing like a Hindus and coming to dance. I said, what is this you all are doing? Some Hindu, oh, you have come, all the old people came bouncing on me. You have come to tell us this? You know, otherwise you go back. You know the story of this Mussoor dance? He said, I said, I don't know. This is from Kadama's time that we have to dance. If we don't dance, it does bad for us. And one boy of each house has to dress like a Hindu and perform this dance near the chapel, which was Mahadeva temple before. Now is Santiago's chapel. They dance there and go to each house. And the lady member of the house has to stay with a lamp outside as a sign that they are welcome. This thing starts the... It's starting the... A sign for the people to dress up and come.
Oh, yes?
Yeah.
But it looks like a gun.
Yeah, those are this thing.
And it comes from the chapel there?
Chapel, there they...
Like, and every day they do this?
Every day.
So you need to go to the chapel now. So please. Wow, this looks like war.
War, no. It's not a war.
Tell me, Nikolov, you are a Catholic.
I'm Catholic.
But you still follow your Hindu ancestral traditions.
Yeah. पण ये आम्ही हिंदू पहिले हिंदू आले न. आमचे पूर्वज हिंदू न पहिले. When Portuguese come, they were not happy. Portuguese ते happy ना झालो. ते हारे हारा जे किने मोडपाक मुटाले ते. तेणी इंगा यो फुरीस मानलो. मांड केलो आनी ती हारी आहरा ते सांत्याग साहेबाचो केलो. सांत्याग साहेबाचो खेळ म्हूण केलो. बिकॉज दे वेर हॅप्पी वीथ द सेंट्स एन्ड देन वी हॅव दीस सॉंग फॉर हिम. फर्स्ट आय प्रे फॉर हिम, आफ्टर प्रे आय हॅव टू सिंग. ओके Om Vishwara Holy Vara Sat Se Guna Gaja Gauri Om. Now I have to start this dance. Nobody else.
So you're entitled to start the dance. Nobody else.
Nobody else.
You are the muli of the gang.
Yeah, I'm the muli of the gang.
And tujh fatlyang kon magir?
Tujh fatlyang hai to mujhe chale hai dalu orla hai to. To na dalar? Mujhe dusra chale hai to. Dusra na tisra hai to. Ami kawa dal mudo ko zani kona koi to lena. But trash is amche burge hai to interest hai no. Tay mein yeh ko dae.
So the young generation is all interested.
Yeah. With my grandson also, they dress and they come. And our women also interested. Harihara cho pedo pedo ta pedo Durga bai shivarota o pedo Durga bai shivarota. Ek, don, tin. Ek, don, tin. Ek, don, tin. Like that, you know.
Traditionally, many Catholics, even today, go to the temples because they say historically it was their deity. So they have not forgotten the roots. They still, the Portuguese or the religious authorities could not segregate these two communities altogether because they had their faith. And the faith was on a particular deity or a deity basically. It could be a Hindu deity. For some Hindus, it could be a Christian deity. It is the faith and hope. They never went on the basis of religion, I feel. They went on the basis of what they could benefit, what they could accrue or get from particular god or deity with whom he pleaded or asked for some favors. And he was pleased with that. It is the hope that has made people to go to this, which again, because they go to each other's place with the hope of revering it, with the hope of getting something for oneself or some benefits or some grace, it is a meeting point where different communities meet. And well, when you meet, there is an automatic psychological behavior in the mind that, oh, he is a Hindu, he is with me, he is a Catholic, he is coming to the temple. Automatically develops in a certain amount of affinity where he respects me and I respect you. So why do we fight? Okay, let us take the feasts of Saint Francis Xavier. Many people hate him because he was the pioneer of conversion. But as time went by, all communities go for the feast of Saint Francis Xavier. They mix because for people it is hope. For people, it is not religion for power or something, it is hope. You may go to any god and if you get your deliverance, you are given what you need, it is God.
In this church, right from the 1577, when the church was built, there were plenty of Hindus here. And they were converted into Christians, Catholics. And they reverted again after 17th century. And that's why all the Hindus who are here, around 4,000 Hindus who are staying around the church and the monument, they come here during novenas and on other days also, like Sundays or Mondays, to offer oil and flowers and the candles for the deity. So they feel Saint Anna, the patron of this parish, take care of them and their families and their children. And the feast of Saint Anna is very much famous throughout India because many Hindus and Muslims come for them to pray to the intercession of Saint Anne to ask for the gift of child. And the couple who were married and did not get children, maybe for 12 years or more than 8 years, 9 years, after coming here and they offer, as their practice and tradition is there, to offer the cucumbers and to pray to the intercession, they offer maybe 4 or 5 cucumbers and they take some after blessing and showing to Saint Anne the statue and they eat it, like I say, prasad in the Hindu temples. and they keep some here and they take some. And afterwards, they come here to thank the deity or Saint Anna with children that they have really received the children from the intercession of Saint Anna through God. This is the specialty of this place. And besides that, so people here come with kulair and they ask for the mulair. That means I offer you this instrument and you give me the wife. And they offer the dolo and they ask for the husband, that is a marido in Portuguese. And like this, they other people also come, newly married couple, after their engagement, they were in troubles not to get married with each other. And after the marriage, and they sort all the problems, and they come with their chudo, what is called the different colorful bangles, and they offer for the deity because they have celebrated their marriage in difficulties and troubles. In the Hindu temples, they take out the palki and the deity observes as the king or queen of the place, of the area, of that particular temple. In the same way, we take out the procession and we proudly proclaim our faith openly that through the intercession of Saint Anna, God bestows on us the blessings and happiness.
O que é curioso na procissão de Saint Anna é a sua semelhança com as cerimónias dos templos hindus, onde um palanquim, um carro que transporta a divindade, o deus ou a deusa hindu, dá literalmente a volta ao templo antes de regressar com a deusa ou com o deus ao altar. Igualmente, as ofertas de flores, pepinos e outros frutos como cocos e bananas acontecem diariamente nos templos hindus e mesmo nas casas dos hindus. Uma capela cristã, católica, e um tulsi, e um lago sagrado hindu. Uma situação não muito vulgar, mas que acontece, visto que os templos cristãos, as igrejas e as capelas foram muitas vezes implantadas no centro das aldeias, ou seja, junto do lago sagrado, que por sua vez tinha sempre um templo ao pé. E portanto, este é talvez o superlativo de um sincretismo em que temos uma capela que, em vez do cruzeiro, tem um tulsi. A presença do tulsi na cultura hindu é constante. Todas as casas hindus têm um tulsi. Do mesmo modo que em Goa, todas as casas cristãs têm uma cruz, um cruzeiro, que faz com que Goa, se calhar, possa ser considerado como o local no mundo com mais cruzes por metro quadrado. É fascinante. Encontram-se cruzes em todos os quintais, em todas as casas. Esperemos que tenha gostado de estar connosco e que tenhamos sido suficientemente eloquentes sobre o que é este fenómeno do sincretismo religioso em Goa. E esperamos estar convosco de novo, 2 a 15 dias, no próximo Contacto Goa.